The Critical Thinker, written and published by Engaslife. Thinking critically is crucial for navigating through life's intricate problems and making wise choices. However, a lot of people have not yet acquired the mindset needed for successful critical thinking. We tend to make quick decisions, draw premature conclusions, and let our biases and emotions influence our thinking. This book offers a clear guide for developing the mindset and methodical approach required to think critically regularly. The Critical Thinker provides you with 10 key lessons to help them develop and practice the core components of critical thinking in a clear and straightforward manner. You will discover how to listen attentively and ask insightful questions when facing challenges, collect and analyze information objectively, take into account various viewpoints, and evaluate the reasoning behind various solutions. This book provides practical strategies for improving decision-making. By organizing your thoughts, seeking input from others, reviewing your processes, and finding mentorship, The Critical Thinker is a must-read for people looking to enhance their mental clarity, gain deeper insights into important issues, and make thoughtful decisions in various aspects of life. By embracing the critical thinking mindset described in this material, you will learn to tackle problems in a proactive manner, make sound judgments, and feel more self-assured in dealing with challenging and uncertain scenarios. Start enhancing your critical thinking skills today by incorporating the valuable lessons in The Critical Thinker. Lesson 1. Practice active listening as much as possible. Active listening is an essential communication technique that helps promote understanding among people. Active listening involves putting in effort to accurately understand the speaker's message, unlike passive listening where there is minimal engagement. Active listening is a crucial interpersonal skill that helps establish relationships based on clarity, interpretation, and trust. Active listening is crucial for critical thinking, helping to develop focus, analytical skills, and ethical discourse necessary for rational evaluation. A thoughtful approach to absorbing information before reacting can help in asking insightful questions that lead to wisdom. Continuously improving involves strengthening these habits through various interactions. The journey starts by recognizing our tendency to get distracted and pass judgment when others are speaking, which can make it difficult to understand them. Always give others the benefit of the doubt before making quick judgments about their beliefs. Watch for body language signals such as crossed arms or eye rolling that don't align with what is being said. Intentionally move into welcoming postures without letting preconceived notions get in the way at first. Begin conversations by mentally preparing yourself to stay neutral and focus solely on the speaker's expressions without immediately adding your own opinions or disagreements. Imagine thoughts flowing into your mind just as they are expressed, without altering or questioning them until fully understood. Witnessing connection in this moment helps develop habits that allow for a deeper understanding by pausing reactions. When controversial topics come up and you're struggling to keep calm, try using emotional words to identify feelings like anger, disgust, or contempt internally, instead of shutting down opposing opinions too quickly. Practice taking quick breaths to calm down before discussing your feelings in a respectful manner. Plan some follow-up questions to ensure understanding and enhance conversations during casual dialogues. Preparing questions shows that communication is important, encouraging people to listen carefully after speaking. During professional conferences, seek short mentoring sessions with experienced leaders who excel in critical thinking across various fields such as academics, journalism, and systems analysis. They are skilled at filtering out distractions to uncover the truth. Ask about their habits to ensure productive results, which rely on carefully selected inputs after being patient. Apply those insights right away when going back to regular discussions filled with unfiltered reactions. Before reacting emotionally to your friend's questionable statements or giving feedback on their ideas, ask them to explain their reasoning first. By providing space for thorough explanation, people can often discover their own mistakes or misunderstandings without conflict. After witnessing intense conflicts between partners, colleagues, and siblings that escalate due to emotional reactions and lack of communication, it can be helpful to introduce studies that demonstrate the benefits of learning listening skills in conflict resolution classes, guide others by setting a positive example and avoiding making quick judgments as tensions decrease. Explore local nonprofit mediation services or peer counseling hotlines to volunteer for sessions assisting disputants through guided listening exchanges aimed at fostering mutual understanding. Instead of focusing on assigning blame right away, this experience provides techniques and strategies to help overcome defensive routines that hinder transparency between rivals when compromise is needed. Make sure to use those tools whenever conflicts arise in your surroundings. When assessing debates among candidates or causes vying for support, try to avoid immediate emotional reactions. Start by identifying the main priorities and concerns of each group by actively listening and interpreting their needs. First, analyze which competing visions appear most reasonable or show the most good faith by asking constructive questions. Following this order of operations enhances logical thinking. To ease tensions during social media debates, try asking what positive principles the opposition values that we may share behind the scenes. Imagining humanity beneath conflict can lead to patience and listening, offering the benefit of the doubt first. Use this basic starting method regularly when you feel triggered. When significant new policies, research, or theories are released that deserve attention, avoid making quick judgments and immediately criticizing. Begin by dedicating time to carefully listen to various accounts from original sources and expert interpretations over the course of several days. Take the time to fully understand the nuances and context from different perspectives before establishing firm opinions. Plan regular team meetings at work centered on project risks, assumptions, and decision validation. Encourage everyone to participate by listening during the initial discussion. Set rules for the first speaker to explain without interruption. Then make sure all opinions are recorded before starting the discussion. These devices help develop understanding. When strong emotions about current events lead to impulsive social media posts, try to avoid the urge to share your opinions right away. Take the time to listen to different perspectives before reacting. Consider saving initial thoughts in a drafts folder to revisit later when your understanding becomes clearer with time. During public discussions, focus on celebrity mishaps or clever remarks instead of important ideas. It's important to redirect the conversation to the main issues and priorities by asking respectful questions and avoiding superficial distractions. Ask people from different perspectives what initially attracted them to get involved to discover the underlying values. While coworkers present project proposals or friends discuss creative concepts, pay attention to immediate doubts that might indicate closed-minded inner critics who are not open to new possibilities. Instead, try to be thoughtful and open-minded when hearing initial ideas. Identify bias by tactfully asking about potential future success first. Plan regular family meetings where everyone can share their frustrations without feeling pressured to find immediate solutions. Start by prioritizing active listening to fully grasp the emotional contexts that are currently hindering cooperation. By separating emotional conversations from problem solving, solving modes, you can improve communication skills and effectively manage home life. When significant new theories, technologies, or cultural works are introduced that challenge existing worldviews, try to avoid automatically defending past expertise out of pride. Simply shift your perspective by listening to various viewpoints in different fields, then carefully readjust. In the time of dealing with career uncertainty or looking for life direction changes, have regular conversations with trusted mentors who can help you discover yourself through listening rather than giving direct advice. Solutions can arise naturally by expressing inner struggles to unbiased people who can listen to the issues before responding. Consider where there is still a lack of listening leading to stereotypes, dominating interactions, instead of genuine exposure to real people, even as groups come into more contact. Bravely participate in discussions with opponents in community gatherings, where the focus is on understanding before making assumptions about people. When new research challenges long-held beliefs, try to hold off on reacting with skepticism due to the impact on your worldview. Listen carefully to defenders' responses and critics' arguments supported by evidence before determining any potential paradigm shifts. New technologies such as AI pose a threat to career stability or ethical standards, so it is important to listen carefully to both those who support the advancements and those who are concerned about the potential negative impacts. This approach should prioritize understanding and addressing the anxieties raised, rather than simply reacting impulsively. During election cycles, it's important to ask respectful questions that focus on listening to all sides rather than engaging in heated debates and accusations. Uncover shared frustrations by asking how the status quo has let down your hopes, despite different personalities and promises. As one's cognitive abilities improve with age, gracefully transition into the role of an elder mentor by demonstrating the importance of listening before reacting with intellectual superiority. May your patience in allowing all voices to be heard inspire future generations to continue fostering a civilized society. Assess listening problems by looking at the outcomes of conversations that focus more on reacting than understanding. When relationships, collaborations, and community bonds are strained despite good intentions, it's important to honestly assess the differences between what is heard and what is understood. As you experience growth and transition into new phases of life, it's important to create room for learning from mentors who have already navigated similar paths. Establish consistent communication schedules, openly discuss evolving situations, and be open to adjusting plans to avoid potential pitfalls that can be avoided by learning from experience. As active listening skills improve, it's important to stay alert and avoid slipping back into ineffective habits like getting distracted when the situation is no longer urgent. Continue to strengthen your skills by taking on new challenges while steadily improving your foundational knowledge. Consider listening skills as a lifelong endeavor to create connections and foster mutual understanding. Just like how our bodies need good nutrition to stay healthy, our minds need to actively listen and consider different perspectives to form well-rounded opinions. Prepare yourself for meaningful conversations by reflecting meditatively on your ability to listen. In moments of calm, soft whispers surface and fresh perspectives arise. Lesson 2. Create a list of relevant questions. Improving critical thinking skills starts with developing better questioning habits. Creating lists of thoughtful questions to analyze problems is an important initial step in improving reasoning, evaluating evidence, and making decisions. Examining thinking patterns helps avoid irrationality. Asking strong questions to challenge assumptions regularly improves judgment. Begin by carefully reviewing recent personal decisions to identify any biases, distractions, false dichotomies, or narrow perspectives that led to less than ideal choices list of thought. Provoking questions that, if considered initially, could have led to more effective solutions for future similar situations. Also, consider situations where asking important questions could have prevented confusion by enhancing understanding. When facing challenges with numerous intricate factors, think about important aspects that have not been taken into account yet. Ask about the long-term effects on different groups of people that have not been considered due to limited decision-making resources. Ask trusted advisors to provide their top three questions if they were responsible for making the final decision, and compare them with the internal list. Work through the process while addressing any gaps in detail. If you're faced with provocative news or online commentary, take a moment to ask neutral questions about where it came from, the contexts, sources, different perspectives, and any hidden interests involved. Pause, reacting emotionally, and instead analyze the complexities behind sensational news to gain a more accurate understanding. Hold off on forming opinions until you've satisfied your curiosity. While watching arguments end abruptly without resolution, look into which areas of investigation need more attention initially. Identify all possible assumptions about motivations and intentions that have not been confirmed by the parties involved. Ask questions that can help uncover each participant's perspective without causing conflict, and do so in a respectful manner. While making important decisions, list all possible ways things could go wrong and brainstorm worst-case scenarios to prepare for unexpected changes. Check your current risk protections by considering any oversights, gaps, or lessons from history that have not been explored yet in case of unexpected events. Begin a collaborative journal with friends focused on creating thought, provoking questions for personal development in areas such as relationships, work, habits, and mindset. Discover vulnerabilities and enhance awareness of blind spots by taking turns, presenting challenges, and reflecting on them. Over time, you will gather a lot of valuable insights from the questions. Create a list of clear and insightful questions for well-known experts to discuss topics that match their expertise. Focus on expertise. Focus on exploring how people apply their life experiences to replicate success rather than just recounting historical events. Question what signs indicated their rise, what obstacles almost stopped their advancement, and what key principles now shape their daily decisions towards long-term success. Before starting a research project, it's important to question why current sources are not meeting your curiosity and why further investigation is needed. Investigate the dominant paradigms in established narratives and how presenting contradictory evidence later can help reveal the truth. Create research questions that address unsupported claims directly instead of just filling in gaps in existing knowledge. It's crucial when making decisions to consider all possible scenarios related to duties, stakeholders, assumptions, metrics, priorities, and time horizons that may have been initially overlooked. Ask outside parties to review inquiry lists for blind spots, then reassess decisions accordingly. When explaining complicated ideas to a large audience, use a series of progressively more detailed questions to help hesitant participants open up slowly and without conflict. Begin by asking specific questions to identify similarities. Then gradually expand the discussion to address any uncertainties. Pause when you feel uncomfortable. You can look for experienced mentors who demonstrate the abilities you aim to achieve. Please provide examples of challenging situations you have encountered in the past that tested your expertise, as well as some insightful questions that helped you gain a better understanding. These can be valuable for gaining perspective when dealing with new and unfamiliar challenges. Assign specific team members to play devil's advocate and question the feasibility of proposed ideas before investing resources. Ask them to investigate previous similar issues in other areas. Consider the complexity of the delivery that may be underestimated, and be aware of hidden risks that could disrupt timelines significantly. When evaluating complicated decisions that different groups within families, organizations, and governments disagree on, start by checking if the arguments are based on unchallenged false limitations. Consider exploring alternative methods to access the necessary resources initially. Always look for discrepancies between stated values and where resources are actually being allocated, which can hide the true conflicts over priorities. When communication becomes unclear in personal relationships, it's important to pinpoint the underlying issues by asking thoughtful questions that respect each person's perspective. Start by understanding what each person wants and work your way back from there. If a clear vision for the future does not come together, it may be helpful to set aside discussions about the past for now and focus on exploring hopes and aspirations separately from old ways of thinking. When you notice communities, companies, or colleagues facing challenges in making progress despite having resources, it's important to consider what false assumptions might be restricting their range of possible solutions. Explore alternative options beyond the usual incremental approaches to achieve significant progress through innovative combinations. Assessing wellness routines to enhance personal performance requires you to ask question assumptions about diet, exercise, and recovery that sports science may have oversimplified for your specific needs. Experts are advocating for universal solutions while studying principles from anthropology and longevity hotspots around the world. Before wrapping up any new learning, make a list of insights that are now clearly confirmed and areas where you still have low confidence, which may need further investigation as your understanding grows. Organize those unclear points into thought, provoking questions that inspire ongoing curiosity, keeping the quest for understanding alive even after formal education ends. When coaching upcoming talents who need help being more assertive in challenging power structures that hinder their new ideas, focus on teaching them how to ask specific questions that target logical inconsistencies, lack of evidence, and potential risks of sticking to unsatisfactory norms instead of directly questioning the leaders. After the weak arguments fall apart, progress moves forward in a positive direction. Start by asking each party about their desired future outcomes and motivations over reasonable timeframes when mediating conflicts. Understanding the true goals and motivations behind negotiations is essential for reaching satisfying long-term solutions. When you're feeling emotional or going through a change in perspective, it's helpful to jot down important questions to think about later when you're feeling more settled. Organizing random thoughts for later reflection allows for deeper self-examination and growth. It's important to challenge historical assumptions, question outdated constraints, and expand imagination to consider new possibilities for innovation when pushing for structural change in resistant cultures. This can help prevent broken systems from persisting long after they are no longer useful. Advancement relies on looking beyond what conformity justifies. When experts in various fields appear to reach a plateau in their progress, it is important to investigate how seeking comfort in the praise of peers for their past achievements might lead them to focus on making small improvements rather than taking risks to bring about major changes. Please ask which assumptions need to be challenged in order to make progress. As you gain more experience, it's important to question things in a productive way. Make sure to focus on habits that challenge assumptions you may not have thought about before. You can do this by meditating regularly, reading philosophy, having open discussions with people who have different beliefs, and surrounding yourself with groups that value honesty over just agreeing with each other. Continuously developing curiosity by questioning norms, exploring blind spots, and challenging the status quo is key to advancing as a high-impact thinker. Consistently updating lists of questions about different aspects of life leads to ongoing discoveries as questioning skills improve. Seeking absolute certainty on intricate matters can be overwhelming, but compiling detailed questions can help fill knowledge gaps effectively as circumstances evolve. Developing a strong sense of curiosity helps people transition from inflexible thinkers to flexible lifelong learners who are ready to face unexpected challenges. If you're wondering why it's important to improve your questioning skills despite the abundance of information available, just think about the unsolved problems in health, conflict, and inequality that continue to affect humanity every day. These issues persist because we are surrounded by brilliance, but often struggle to think beyond our current limitations. Advancement is ready for those who excel in sharp questioning. Lesson 3. Be the one who start conversation first. Initiating conversation first helps develop critical thinking skills as it prompts us to articulate and clarify our thoughts. When starting a conversation, it's important to turn unclear ideas into clear words and ask questions that help move the discussion forward. We need to synthesize concepts, simplify explanations, and choose vocabulary that accurately conveys our meaning. Simply put, initiating conversations helps develop crucial communication skills needed for analytical thinking. Moreover, starting a conversation encourages us to consider different perspectives shared in response. We prioritize active listening over immediate reaction. This helps in learning humility, nuance, and intellectual flexibility. Initiating discussions first can prevent the reflexive counterargument mindset that hinders meaningful debate by causing early disagreement. When we start a conversation, we usually pick topics that we are unsure about, interested in, or bothered by. This brings us to explore topics in a more open manner, free from preconceived notions or personal biases. We are driven to conduct in-depth research to ensure the accuracy of the knowledge we provide. Our questions serve as gateways for shared exploration, rather than as efforts to demonstrate our correctness. Therefore, starting a conversation can steer discussions away from narrow-minded conflict. Moreover, taking the lead in initiating exchanges allows us to gain unique insights that may not be obtained through just observing passively. Revelation comes naturally when we ask thoughtful questions that lead to unexpected answers. When we wait for others to start the conversation, we might miss out on the valuable insights each person can offer when they are directly asked to share their point of view. Speaking up first allows every voice to contribute to the collective understanding. Starting a conversation leads to a joint effort of continuous input. When initiating a conversation, it's important to keep it going by responding attentively and openly without taking over the discussion once you've asked the first questions. Speaking up first can often encourage others to do the same. Initiating conversation shows leadership, encourages active participation, and allows more reserved people to feel comfortable participating. Moreover, initiating meaningful discussions fosters a sense of community and human bonding. When we start and then maintain conversations, we build connections through sharing vulnerabilities, understanding, and being true to ourselves. We move conversations from confrontational arguments among groups to personal exchanges among acquaintances. We acknowledge the shared humanity within our diverse world. Trust is built when people choose to speak constructively and compassionately instead of remaining silent. Engaging in conversations helps improve critical thinking skills by providing regular opportunities to practice social skills. Skills such as engaging in casual conversation, asking open-ended questions, restating information for better understanding, addressing sensitive topics, and practicing active listening can deteriorate if we always rely on others to initiate the conversation. Consistently starting conversations helps us improve our ability to handle more challenging discussions when necessary. It is important to carefully assess situations before engaging in conversations without prior consideration. Some environments may not be open to questioning and could be hostile instead of encouraging healthy discussions. At times, we all face informal social consequences for speaking openly, especially about sensitive subjects. We can best serve truth and progress by accepting these social growing pains. Being overly cautious can lead to missed chances for learning and growth through sharing knowledge. Some questions should only be asked when you are prepared to hear the answers, according to Norwegian author Marie Takvam. How can you be prepared if you never ask questions? Expressing confusion, objections, or unconventional perspectives benefits society by highlighting areas that require further investigation. Avoiding challenging conversations only leads to unresolved issues festering. Choosing when to speak up is important in navigating political situations, but always staying silent can hinder personal and societal growth. Maurice Blondel, the philosopher, suggested that moral progress is achieved through compromise rather than avoidance, without encouraging a genuine reconsideration of traditional norms. Mainstream thinking comes to a standstill. Thoughtful communication paves the way for progress. Starting a conversation can often feel uncomfortable or unsafe, even when discussing simple topics. Social consequences can be subtle, while asking questions may result in strong negative reactions. However, navigating conversations can also help develop qualities such as courage, conviction, and leadership. Steering clear of risky exchanges hinders personal growth and societal progress. In short, initiating conversations, even if awkward, helps people practice expressing ideas, learn from different perspectives, create a community, and develop social skills. Restricting our conversations to safe, insignificant topics means missing out on a wealth of meaningful experiences just waiting to be shared. Thus, in navigating politicized contexts, it is important to embrace the courage to voice half-formed doubts, unconventional theories, challenging critiques, and quirky questions before perfecting the wording. Unexpected inspiration arises from interactions. Share your thoughts and let understanding grow. Initiating a conversation can prevent potential risks. To start a fruitful conversation, pick a topic that piques your interest. Delve into topics that truly puzzle or concern you, prompting introspection or sparking ideas for change. Engaging in conversations just for the sake of being polite can lead to uninteresting interactions that may not push you to question your beliefs or discover new insights. Choose a topic that ignites your passion for truth. First, establish an intention that focuses on fostering mutual understanding rather than winning arguments or proving your point. Embrace the initial confusion and engage in discussions with a sincere desire to fill gaps in your current perspective. Approach topics with a mindset of learning rather than judging, even those you are already knowledgeable about. Viewing dialogue as a chance for mutual growth rather than a competition to outdo others instantly raises the level of conversation. Next, seek out people with differing worldviews and make a point to include their perspectives in your discussions. Surrounding ourselves with similar people fosters unity, but true cognitive development comes from stepping outside our comfort zones and confronting our blind spots. Creating diversity requires deliberate action because we often lean towards uniformity due to unconscious social filtering. Challenge that automatic isolation on purpose. When you're ready to start a conversation, you can make it less awkward by first finding common ground through positive statements that are not controversial. Before moving on to more complex subjects, address concerns by acknowledging common goals, values, or cultural references. This establishes a solid foundation of trust, making it easier to address more challenging topics later on. People are more likely to listen attentively when they feel heard and respected. Begin by asking your question sincerely. Making sure it is clear and shows genuine curiosity. Explain curiosity in a way that others can understand, being open about not knowing everything. Ask straightforward questions to gain deeper insights from experts in the field. This modest stance encourages more involved and enlightening replies from those you are conversing with. Pay close attention to comprehend the conversation as it progresses. Encourage others to expand on their thoughts by listening quietly, using positive body language, and summarizing their points for better understanding. Make sure to thoroughly understand different viewpoints before offering criticism. Listening before sharing your own perspectives can enhance the depth of the conversation. Reacting quickly disrupts the process of collectively exploring important issues to uncover incorrect assumptions. When countering, start by acknowledging points of agreement to reduce defensiveness, then address areas of differing interpretation respectfully. Politely inquire about how your conversation partner views any philosophical flaws you identify in their reasoning. Get rid of complex words that might cause shame instead of clarity. This gentle Socratic questioning method helps maintain thoughtful discussions by exposing logical gaps without causing offense. Furthermore, make sure to regularly recap the main topics discussed and request feedback from your partners to ensure you have understood their key points correctly. This evaluates biases by requiring a fair and accurate analysis of perspectives different from your own. You enhance mutual understanding, correct inaccuracies, and prepare dialogue for more meaningful progression in this collaborative truth-seeking process. If some questions become emotionally charged or repetitive, take a break and recognize the shared frustration, acknowledging the complexity of the situation. First, express gratitude to your conversation partners for their engagement up to this point before proposing a different approach to exploring topics. Offer potential choices and then ask for input from the group on the best way to shift focus. This helps maintain a positive outlook, guides towards new insights, and encourages staying engaged in important conversations even when progress is not straightforward. Not all exchanges end with everyone agreeing. When there are disagreements that cannot be resolved, just make it clear when personal opinions clash with facts to avoid reaching an agreement. Celebrate clarifying assumptions in different social situations, even without complete agreement. Challenge outdated stereotypes, gain a new understanding of opposing viewpoints, and find inspiration for future directions. Thank your conversation partners for sharing their perspectives and enriching your mental models, even though they may not be identical yet. After starting the conversation, remember to ask more questions as it continues. When the conversation slows down, introduce new perspectives that encourage deeper self-reflection for both you and others. Make sure not to take over the conversation once you start it. Your goal is to encourage open communication rather than seek attention. Keep making mental notes about your desire for more analysis while also allowing others to speak. Afterwards, take time to think about what you learned from conversations, reconsidering important questions that your previous assumptions didn't fully answer and recognizing the social biases that influence those gaps in knowledge. Provide a clear plan for continuous learning to further develop your newly transformed perspective through constant exploration. Going back to discussions later helps solidify important lessons and encourages more learning through self-guided study. Engaging in regular reflective conversations, even when they are challenging, helps develop a more critical mindset for everyday communication. Intentionally creating a variety of thought-provoking discussions helps develop skills and self-control, enabling you to use better reasoning without even realizing it in everyday situations. Keep focused on achieving a breakthrough. In short, when we choose interesting topics, engage with challenging partners, prioritize understanding, ask questions without judgment, and balance scrutiny with listening, we improve our critical thinking skills through the simple act of starting conversations thoughtfully. Lesson 4. Try to understand the other person's point of view. Trying to understand different perspectives helps us think critically about complex issues. Suspending judgment allows us to see issues from different perspectives, challenging our assumptions, uncovering cultural blind spots, and connecting different social groups. Reacting instinctively against unfamiliar perspectives can hinder our ability to think beyond the biases we gain from our own life experiences. When we choose to explore different analytical frameworks, we can uncover valuable insights that our usual thinking may overlook. We consider different perspectives on the reasons for behaviors we typically overlook or criticize. Our broader viewpoint now uncovers nuances in complex interactions we once viewed too simplistically. Adopting foreign cognitive models may feel unnatural at first and requires overriding primordial instinct. Our minds naturally process new information based on our upbringing and personal experiences. However, using automatic positioning for daily tasks can be efficient, but when applied without thought to complex social problems, it can limit the exploration of innovative solutions. By exploring different ways of explaining things, we can improve our ability to remain unbiased. Dealing with challenging situations involves grasping the motives of all people through intellectual role play. We are most effective at persuading others when we acknowledge and understand the various needs and limitations that lead to different behaviors, and then gradually uncover shared interests. We resolve conflicts by recognizing the value in different perspectives shaped by diverse experiences. In order to provide a thoughtful response, it is important to consider complex issues from the perspective of our partners. Aside from settling disagreements, grasping different viewpoints also protects us from being manipulated. Understanding others' reasoning well enough to anticipate their self-serving tactics helps us identify dishonest framing. Knowing different types of analyses helps us question things skeptically and point out inconsistencies or missing information strategically. Looking at the bigger picture helps us evaluate claims independently rather than just accepting them without question. Although our natural inclination is to stick to what we know, moving forward requires incorporating new and unconventional ideas into common thinking. Studies indicate that teams including external perspectives outperform those led by people with similar thinking patterns. New perspectives from different worldviews lead to innovative breakthroughs. Without being open to understanding different mental models, we tend to dismiss their groundbreaking ideas as ignorant instead of visionary. Trying to understand completely new perspectives can be overwhelming at first. If our life experiences don't provide any natural starting points for basic understanding. However, striving for a basic comprehension broadens our theoretical scope as we slowly gain more insight. Posing questions about specific details in new philosophies helps develop the ability to understand different perspectives beyond our usual scope. Progress builds up over time. Developing skills for understanding different cultures also helps people grow personally. Experimenting with new value systems helps develop qualities like open-mindedness, tolerance, and willingness to learn. We become more at ease with incomplete impressions rather than hastily jumping to incorrect conclusions. We embrace incomplete understanding instead of completely rejecting unfamiliar territory that we can't immediately grasp. Our complex thinking embraces contradictions and ambiguities that go beyond simple black and white choices. Exploring different perspectives can reveal shared values beneath disagreements. Although people have different life experiences that influence their priorities, most people ultimately desire safety, dignity, and a sense of community. Identifying these shared roots enables us to base discussions on common values instead of divisive distinctions. Understanding others on a deeper level makes it difficult to rely on stereotypes. Engaging with conflicting mental frameworks too soon can lead to losing one's own direction without first building a solid philosophical base. People who are not confident in their self-awareness may end up giving up their natural talents while trying to achieve objectivity that is hard to grasp. We can best convey truth by embracing our people perspectives, as long as they are rooted in ethical intentions. Putting others before oneself may seem neutral, but it does not lead to true growth. However, we don't have to completely give up our own perspective forever in order to develop by being open to other viewpoints. Occasionally adopting new perspectives can help you reflect on yourself before returning to your usual way of thinking. We are now better equipped to use our usual perspective after realizing its limitations and considering other perspectives that offer new insights. Our unique talents enhance by expanding our influence. It is important to grasp conflicting viewpoints to foster diverse and insightful communities capable of addressing complex common issues. Separation arises from being closed off, while collaborative analysis relies on incorporating various perspectives. Open interchange necessitates that participants understand their own and others' fundamental assumptions. Validation is essential for engaging in productive debates and discovering creative solutions. Seeking to genuinely comprehend opposing perspectives helps develop the skills and instincts that critical thinkers require to move beyond the constraints of one-sided viewpoints acquired from birth. By exploring different philosophies, we question ingrained assumptions, broaden our understanding, and develop the wisdom needed to navigate a complex world. Putting aside one's ego to briefly see things from another's perspective is crucial for making progress. Simply put, embracing different perspectives helps us expand. Suspending our own perspective allows for new insights to emerge. Simple habits based on limited life experiences must sometimes give way to higher truths revealed through multiple dimensions. Our core identity is rooted in personal history. But we need to make a conscious effort to see things from different perspectives to avoid being limited by our own thinking. Consider how alternate angles can help you see things you may have missed. There is a whole new world waiting to be explored. Lesson 5. Apply frameworks to structure and organize your thinking. Organized analysis is essential for critical thinking, rather than reacting in a disjointed manner. Choosing conceptual frameworks before analyzing complex issues helps provide structure for evaluating various aspects in the right context. Similar to how builders use architectural plans to create strong buildings. Critical thinkers develop intellectual scaffolding to form solid conclusions. Without structured outlines to organize insights systematically as we gather and connect them, our brains tend to jump between snippets that are too fragmented for coherent synthesis. We overlook important cause and effect relationships, focus on main consequences, and identify incorrect assumptions without a formal strategy to connect findings cohesively and prevent irrelevant information or inconsistencies. Frameworks bring order to complex chaos. Choosing the right evaluative frameworks ensures that your research goals match the desired analytical results. Efforts are wasted when our investigative approach lacks a clear purpose and boundaries, leading us to chase irrelevant insights and peripheral tangents. By establishing specific end goals and selecting the right support structures, research can be directed towards relevant discoveries. This helps avoid a large amount of scattered data from piling up without coming together to form clear answers. There are various interpretive templates available for organizing thoughts, such as SWOT analysis, Porter's 5 Forces, 6 Sigmas to Make, design thinking principles, decision matrix models, and many others, each tailored to specific domains. Getting to know popular frameworks, inventories broadens our choices to tackle specific challenges. We steer clear of difficulties by using appropriate templates for specific situations. Choosing the right mental models helps to view the issue in the correct perspective. Even without specialized training, basic step-by-step binary checklists created to address specific issues can be more effective than complex paradigms that don't quite fit. Breaking down complex ideas into simple steps is more helpful for beginners than trying to understand complicated theoretical models. Begin with the fundamentals and then expand your knowledge. When analyzing, make sure to jot down any new insights at each stage of our evaluation process to avoid getting lost in the middle of a complicated assessment. Summarize key themes. Review initial notes regularly for reference. Document unanswered questions for future research, and identify areas for further investigation to strengthen initial ideas. Careful monitoring following a set plan helps maintain clarity when dealing with complex situations that are hard to remember. Be open to adjusting initial structures if they turn out to be flawed in some way. Sticking stubbornly to inappropriate models due to ego-driven denial of their flaws can distort the analysis of complex situations, forcing them into rigid structures instead of adapting to their natural shapes. Allow reality to shape things instead of trying to make details fit into a theory that doesn't match. Setting a strong mental foundation before starting analysis greatly enhances the logic of conclusions more than just having good intentions, clear questions, collected data, or commitment without a structured process. Effective scaffolding can elevate average materials, whereas even the best ingredients will fail without a solid structure to support them. The way something is organized influences the result. We enhance the credibility of our conclusions by submitting final analyses to external public scrutiny instead of keeping them private, in addition to structuring inquiry processes. Receiving feedback helps identify any biased blind spots or weak logical links that may have been overlooked when setting up the initial architectural parameters. Feedback enhances future designs by subjecting them to stress tests from various perspectives. When dealing with polarized social climates and differing benchmarking standards among ideological groups, external input can sometimes hinder clarity instead of improving it. When facing such situations, it is crucial to seek out critics who can offer fair feedback instead of outright rejection due to differing values. This approach helps in gaining valuable insights from the review process. Get rid of comments that are not based on ethical fairness or relevant evidence. Remember, achieving a shared understanding involves piecing together complex puzzles that may not always have a clear-cut solution. We need to talk about the acceptable levels of ambiguity within specific contexts. Even the most straightforward conclusions may have uncertainties when considering variables like temporal change or unpredictability. Explain the level of certainty needed in relation to the acceptable doubt levels for each unique situation. In summary, start by choosing an evaluation template or creating an investigative checklist for specific topics. Track all new insights against this outline, update frameworks as needed, and submit final conclusions for review. This approach helps in conducting thorough critical analysis in challenging contexts. Organized mental framing is the fundamental structure supporting advanced reasoning. Prior to posing a question, determine the type of answer you are looking for, and then choose the appropriate steps to guide you towards it. Getting lost in a maze without a map or choosing random paths can lead to losing your way. Once the foundation of your framework is solid, construct each parallel beam carefully through its levels until the overarching conclusions come together at the top. Establishing a strong infrastructure paves the way for future visionaries. Lesson 6. Research and gather factual information. Thorough research is essential for effective critical thinking before making conclusions. By gathering factual information instead of making assumptions, we can create accurate mental models of complex dynamics. Building a strong comprehension involves delving further. No analysis can cover all information. We need to figure out the amount of knowledge required for reliable appraisals, considering constraints on available data, interpreter biases, and decision. Making deadlines. Establish these boundaries and concentrate on fundamental facts within the defined scope to achieve specific research objectives. Focus on fundamental truths before expanding the scope. Focus on seeking out solid evidence from reliable sources rather than relying on opinions or personal stories. Facts provide the basis for reasoning by confirming their accuracy. Start by establishing fundamental principles to build solid theoretical foundations before drawing conclusions. Conclusions are only as strong as the data they are based on, even if they are presented persuasively. The most important thing is the substance. Assess sources carefully. By checking for transparency of data, corroboration from multiple studies, researcher credentials and affiliations, sample demographics, and disclosure of funding interests that may impact bias. Set clear standards to distinguish reliable information from manipulated or false data. Examine the trustworthiness of statistical interpretations by assessing the methods used to produce quantified results. Consider factors such as the range of measurement errors, characteristics of the sample groups, sufficient sample sizes, accuracy of analytical computations, precautions against making broad assumptions, and potential variables that could affect correlations. Be cautious not to make incorrect conclusions based on basic statistics. Thoroughly research from a variety of sources with different perspectives to counteract biases that may occur when focusing too narrowly on one channel, even when trying to be objective. Examining various perspectives on issues reveals a broader range of important factors that may be missed from a limited viewpoint. Deliberately inclusive research broadens perspectives. Collect qualitative examples that provide rich context and capture subjective nuances that quantitative datasets cannot. Personal narratives sharing cultural experiences can provide valuable insights that might be overlooked in statistical analyses of larger population trends. Quantitative and qualitative inputs work together to address problems at both large and high levels at the same time. Combine empirical and emotional intelligence. Make sure to take detailed notes on all researched facts, bookmark sources for easy reference, and rate them based on credibility and relevance. Explain how the findings either support or challenge previous assumptions. Identify any inconsistencies that require further investigation, and cite evidence that connects different discoveries found in various sources. This level of transparency enhances credibility. If you encounter a topic that is too complex for your understanding, it's best to consult experienced researchers, academics, or professionals with expertise in that area before making any conclusions. We can best represent truth by being humble and recognizing our limitations, rather than making mistakes due to overconfidence beyond our expertise. It's important to seek guidance when needed. There is a lot of conflicting information on various issues these days due to increasing polarization. Navigating through complex information to identify the truth can be challenging for ordinary people who don't have the time to delve deeply into intricate discussions. This disrupts the common understanding of fundamental societal issues. Despite facing challenges, it is crucial to build strong evidence to create convincing arguments that can sway skeptics holding on to different beliefs. Although it's rare to reach complete agreement on controversial issues, conducting thorough research without bias distortions or logical errors can greatly enhance the quality of discussions. Advancement is sparked by honesty. By seeking factual inputs, vetting sources, cross-checking details, documenting the evidentiary trail, and obtaining expert guidance, we can inject truth into ideological conflicts obstructing problem. Solving of urgent threats. It's impossible for any analysis to fully cover extremely complex topics. However, choosing not to conduct any research ensures a lack of knowledge. Despite its flaws, engaging in honest, critical discussions to unite opposing groups is crucial for avoiding potential crises that could have serious consequences. If truth is still important, we must be willing to search for it, even in times of uncertainty. By questioning assumptions, expanding context, prioritizing primary sources, vetting credibility, cross-checking bias, noting methodology, gathering subjective insights, documenting meticulously, seeking expert guidance, and committing fully to let discovered factual reality guide rather than preconceived notions override inconvenient truths uncovered through persistence. We revive lost foundations of shared understanding crucial for progress. There are no quick fixes. Get the job done. The fate of civilization is at stake. Lesson 7. Seek feedback from other people. Challenging our thoughts involves seeking constructive criticism to uncover our own reasoning flaws. We all work with limited information and biased viewpoints, which can skew our analysis. By actively seeking feedback from others, we can identify overlooked flaws in our reasoning, enhance comprehension, and create better solutions together. Inviting feedback can lead to feeling embarrassed and requires being humble. many people prefer to hide internal weaknesses rather than be transparent about them. Initiating an external review, despite feeling insecure, can help you grow and reach your full potential. A candle illuminates its surroundings while bravely consuming itself. Therefore, look for constructive feedback. Construct queries in a way that encourages thoughtful responses instead of defensive reactions. Request partners to identify ideas that require more attention to reach their full potential, rather than being considered fundamentally flawed. Structure input requests to support the development of ideas instead of criticizing them. This feedback emphasizes improving promising ideas rather than just focusing on their flaws. Additionally, please clearly state any fundamental beliefs that are essential to your identity and should not be challenged in responses. Considering different viewpoints should not involve disrespecting basic human worth, but can enhance articulation of beliefs by understanding oneself better through reflecting on genuine responses. Recognizing genuine sacred beliefs eliminates defensive behaviors that distort conversations. Kind honesty promotes togetherness. When asking for feedback, it's best to provide your work directly instead of just explaining your ideas. Even when people describe things about themselves, it may not fully capture the true essence and intention of what they are trying to convey, which can only be truly understood by experiencing the creator's work directly. Replacing brief summaries removes complexity and may lead to misunderstanding. Provide tangible content. Include a variety of perspectives from different sources, such as insiders, skeptics, users, experts, and beginners, to ensure a comprehensive approach. Challenging assumptions from different perspectives can help uncover overlooked issues. Having a wide range of input ensures necessary checks and balances. Share appraisal invitations broadly, without focusing solely on people who are likely to be supportive. Feedback loops within supportive social circles can lead to insularity instead of identifying areas for growth. We gain the most knowledge from people who are willing to express differing opinions while still providing thoughtful responses. Question the status quo by incorporating opposing viewpoints. Set up various channels to collect feedback, including private critique sessions to protect speakers and public forums for open discussions. Offer choices for sharing concerns anonymously, if censored for political correctness, while also emphasizing accountable interactions with attribution. Customize the conduit to fit the content and context with care. When you receive negative feedback, try to listen attentively without becoming defensive or immediately responding. Make sure you fully understand the assessor's reasoning before clarifying any original intent that was not properly conveyed or pointing out any remedial recommendations that you currently find unfeasible to adopt. Even poorly worded criticism should be initially approached with an attempt to understand. Listen to critics completely before responding. Make sure to document all suggestions for future review, even if some advice may seem unhelpful at first when shared openly. Take a moment after your emotions have calmed down to review feedback that was awkwardly worded. Look for any hidden meanings that you might have overlooked while feeling uncomfortable about confronting difficult truths. Consider objections before dismissing them. Follow up by revisiting how suggestions enhanced understanding, increased practicality, or were integrated after adjustments to maintain the original essence while incorporating valuable feedback. Appreciating external input encourages continued open teamwork and fosters a mindset of humility. Consistently asking for honest feedback and showing genuine receptiveness in return helps create a safe environment for people to challenge conventional thinking. Over time, teams become stronger as they develop their skills, offering support and accountability. Leaders can let go of their defensive attitudes, understanding that making mistakes is normal, and forgiveness is always an option. Healthy cultures that promote innovation value constructive criticism and encourage open communication. In conclusion, Being open to criticism can help foster intellectual growth, which can be challenging if you only rely on your own thoughts. Our unconscious assumptions restrict our ability to imagine. By exploring various reactions, including strong disagreement, we uncover blind spots crucial for fostering innovative breakthroughs. Advancement necessitates assistance. Let's walk side by side. Even though our ego tends to avoid being transparent to prevent embarrassment, seeking out criticism can help us improve and grow with confidence in our ability to get better over time. Let's embrace our imperfections and support each other in exploring new opportunities. Lesson 8. Critique all options and solutions that emerge. Considering all possible solutions thoroughly enhances decision-making and oversight to avoid biased analysis. By questioning attractive answers, we identify mistakes before accepting them. Advancement relies on providing fair critiques to serve all interests equitably. Make sure to evaluate each option using the same criteria. Avoid the temptation to criticize some while overlooking the flaws in preferred solutions. Consider different approaches to fair accountability that do not have biased standards favoring the familiar over the foreign. Consistency in upholding ethics is crucial for true progress, rather than making excuses based on familiarity. Consider exploring options from a collaborative support perspective, rather than a confrontational elimination approach. Challenging all ideas based on common standards helps improve overall understanding, rather than seeking to establish one perspective as superior. Our aim is to work together to enhance choices that benefit everyone involved. Pinpoint the reasons for issues to find solutions instead of rejecting choices without clarification. Provide detailed feedback on structural weaknesses, unintended consequences, resource deficiencies, implementation roadblocks, and philosophical differences to help collaborators understand the next steps for improvement. Offer suggestions in a constructive manner, focusing on mutual growth by providing additional insights from your own perspective rather than criticizing from a narrow viewpoint. Present critiques as a way to enhance understanding and explore different options, rather than as a means to show superiority and point out the ignorance of others. Providing positive feedback on an option's strengths while addressing areas for improvement creates balance. Make sure to highlight both strengths to keep and weaknesses to improve. Support the brave while also helping those in need. When evaluating a situation, it's important to take the time to consider all aspects before making a decision, as initial reactions may not always align with the best solution. Give yourself time to uncover new insights by carefully considering all options, even those you may have initially dismissed as they may hold hidden value. Stay mindful of personal boundaries and how they influence your perspective during critiques. Strong solutions combine diverse viewpoints to create cohesive wholes that are greater than their people parts. We all exist within confined surroundings. Create an environment that fosters critical thinking and encourages open discussions about how personal beliefs may influence evaluation viewpoints. Openly discuss potential conflicts without attacking people who are struggling to question assumptions ingrained unconsciously through past conditioning. Create room for contemplation. In summary, by evaluating all options against fair standards, asking probing questions, offering constructive suggestions through collaboration, focusing on mutual development, and giving time for insights to emerge naturally, criticism can be a positive force that brings stakeholders together to support solutions that benefit everyone fairly. However, strict questioning that only targets fixing immediate issues can hinder innovation by discouraging creative risk-taking. Use critique to improve collective efforts, not as a tool of authority to set limits based on entitlement. Progress comes from consistently reevaluating, not striving for perfection. Let's keep moving forward. Solutions are dynamic entities, not fixed objects. External environments are constantly changing, constituent support can shift, needs evolve, and new resources emerge. An optimal arrangement that works well now may not be sufficient in the future, if not adjusted accordingly. Our world is facing a critical moment where we need to look beyond immediate gains and consider the bigger picture by taking into account the needs of all stakeholders. We strive to move beyond survival mentalities towards achieving sustainable climate and justice. Lesson 9. Make reflection about yourself regularly. Reflecting on ourselves regularly helps us question the assumptions that may bias our worldview. By bravely exploring underlying beliefs that influence how we assess evidence, we counteract the bias caused by our limited life experiences. To become better critical thinkers, we must reflect on ourselves. During times of significant distortion, when cultural norms prioritize obedience over truth, going against external dogma can lead to harsh consequences. Prioritize safety before sharing thoughts. Once you are confident, actively seek to learn more about yourself. To navigate toxicity, it's important to establish a solid foundation before considering new directions. Reflection is not a simple and easy process, but rather a continuous journey towards maturity with others. Understanding our own complexities can be challenging, let alone judging others. Understanding one's lack of knowledge comes before gaining enlightenment. Be patient and compassionate as you gain wisdom through practice and gradual revelations. Begin by looking back at past events to recognize instinctive responses that may reveal underlying biases. Consider different perspectives when interpreting exchanges to uncover underlying assumptions. Identify ingrained thought patterns that occur automatically, even when they don't align with your conscious beliefs. Revisiting past experiences to uncover underlying motivations helps create a valuable pause between reacting and responding with purpose. When we notice our behavioral patterns, we can adjust our reactions. We can choose not to act on harmful impulses and instead focus on pursuing our goals that were previously overshadowed by instinct. Reflecting not only improves impulse control, but also helps to remember lessons from past experiences to make better decisions in the future. By deriving general principles from specific interactions to apply in different situations, we can better anticipate and handle unexpected challenges. Understanding deepens as similarities appear in different situations. Undoubtedly, first-hand experience is the best way to test conceptual theories and measure their credibility. Testing out ideas on a small scale helps to make improvements quickly before investing in larger projects. Experience setbacks to pave the way for future success through self-reflection. Sharing clear findings from self-assessments encourages feedback from others going through similar experiences who can help us see our weaknesses. Anonymous writing allows for tangible self-critique that can be easily improved through editing, unlike the unconscious burying of excess baggage. Outsource work to make progress more effectively. Create a routine for reflecting by journaling, talking with others who can provide different perspectives, incorporating contemplative practices into your daily life, and setting aside intentional alone time for self-reflection without distractions. Using scaffolding helps maintain consistency during moments of wavering discipline. Create a schedule and designate an area. Compare personal progress over time instead of comparing yourself to others on different paths. External reference scenarios assist in adjusting subjective self-perception, with a focus on effectively transferring principles across different contexts rather than rigid replication. Indeed, pride can sometimes distort self-reflection, leading to self-absorption that shirks responsibility by focusing internally rather than making meaningful contributions externally. However, too much self-criticism can lead to either feeling paralyzed or striving for perfection compulsively. Balance self-confidence and modesty carefully. Establishing a true reflective equilibrium creates positive cycles between taking care of oneself and serving others. producing extra resources internally supports giving to others, while seeking help from outside sources helps establish the necessary support to maintain productivity. Find a balance between taking care of yourself and giving back to others. In short, reviewing our days intentionally, identifying ingrained reactions, expanding behavioral options, retaining transferable lessons, piloting ideas small, processing experiences vulnerably with partners offering alternate angles, and measuring progress longitudinally, against ourselves more than others. Self-reflection helps build critical thinking faculties gradually towards enlightenment when approached as a lifelong developmental journey rather than a quick fix. During uncertain times, it's important to be flexible and adjust how we see ourselves as things change. Quickly changing may be most beneficial for survival right now, even if different parts of yourself are pulling you in different directions temporarily without a clear connection until they come together once the emergency is over and new phases begin. Greater unity is on the horizon, achieved by maintaining genuine presence in the present moment, even in the face of deep contradictions. Everything is fine. Let's keep moving forward. Let's evolve together to embrace more complexity and face the truth. Encouraging genuine authenticity from within rather than enforcing conformity. Have faith in the process. Final lesson. The critical thinker. And that wraps up our straightforward journey through the basics of critical thinking. We have discussed important skills such as active listening, questioning assumptions, considering different perspectives, using reasoning frameworks, collecting facts, asking for feedback, weighing options, and self-reflection to help overcome biased thinking patterns. Engaging in structured practice of these skills helps us develop our ability for open-minded analysis and evidence-based reasoning. However, true critical thinking goes beyond just practice. It is also a mindset. A skilled critical thinker focuses on using various techniques to seek truth over ideology, facts over assumptions, nuance over stereotypes, and understanding over judgment. Having a critical thinking mindset means prioritizing growth over security and being willing to face discomfort when faced with conflicting opinions or complex situations. It values the credibility of conclusions more than people's egos or the assumptions those conclusions challenge. It promotes shared knowledge rather than people power or group control. Simply put, a well-tuned mind always pursues truth, no matter what. Certainly, adopting this mindset goes beyond just intellectual ability. It involves building strong moral habits and developing courageous character virtues through challenges. Blind spots become apparent when ideologies are challenged by reality. Encouraging conformity penalizes people who question assumptions openly. Building critical thinking skills involves not only questioning ingrained beliefs, but also being willing to face social consequences that come with challenging the status quo. You now have the necessary skills for this transformation. The ultimate challenge for critical thinkers is to translate their progress from people thought experiments into ethical, positive actions that promote truth and justice globally. Embracing new awareness means taking on the responsibility of reassessing careers, relationships, and social systems with a fresh perspective, free from preconceived biases and oversights. Readers with a proactive mindset will be able to determine the next steps for making a positive impact based on their people, skills, and situations. Everyone needs to find the bravery to act on the truth they have discovered and can't easily forget. Martin Luther King once cautioned, "There comes a time when silence is betrayal." As poet Maya Angelou famously said, "When you know better, do better." Now you have a better understanding. Follow the path of truth, even if it leads you into uncertainty, controversy, or complexity. Enlightened critical thinkers are needed to shape history towards justice. We rely on insightful minds like yours for our progress. Let's keep moving forward.